r e to the power of I theta, and also find what is f dash of z.
Now, this is u. I have considered this as u, and this part as v. So, when you partially differentiate with respect to r, I get 1 minus k square by r square and cos theta. Partially differentiate with respect to theta for this, you get cos becomes minus sine. Rest is same.
And for v, partially differentiate with respect to r, I get this. Sine theta is same. Partially differentiate with respect to theta, I get this. Sine becomes cos. So this is done. Okay. Now let us see whether it satisfies the Cauchy-Riemann equation or not. To satisfy that, you have ur is equal to 1 by r v theta, and vr is equal to minus 1 by r u theta. So this is satisfied. So this satisfies Cauchy-Riemann equations. Okay. Therefore, the function f of z is analytic. So we have showed that it is analytic, considering z is equal to r e to the power pi theta. Now let us find f dash of z. F dash of z, by using Cauchy-Riemann equation, we have e to the power of minus I theta ur plus I vr. Now ur is this and vr is this. Let us substitute these two. So when I substitute this, and if I take the common thing, which is e to the power of minus I theta, which is outside, so I get this result. Okay. Now if I we know what is cos theta plus I sin theta is e to the power of I theta, and if we have minus here, cos theta minus I sin theta, it is e to the power of minus I theta. So that's what I have done. So e to the power of I theta and e to the power of minus I theta. Now if I take this inside, so e to the power of minus I theta into e to the power of I theta is equal to 1. Okay, if I have plus, so it becomes e to the power of 2 I theta, because I theta plus I theta becomes 2 I theta. So that's what I got. This is 1. Now if you look at this, this is r square and e to the power of 2 I theta. I can put this together and it is r e to the power of I theta whole square. Now what is r e to the power of I theta? This is z. So I substituted it. So this is f dash of z.